might have some questions from the audience.
Sure.
Yes. I'm just going to, not a question, I'm just going to remind you, Carol is trying to check this, that Cuba is also trying to
survive. As an outsider from Cuba, I wonder if there is any other art movement or styles or trends that could ever make it to the American mainstream media, besides the political message. No, I'm not necessarily criticizing you or anything, or
the whole way.
Because like usually what you get to hear from Cuba is the whole struggle, freedom, like, which is totally, I'm all for that. But like, I just want, because I've never been to Cuba, I just wonder, like, because you were talking about, oh yeah, there is some art that might be bad or not, but there's great artists that never really get to, be exposed. So I wonder, like, is there anything, like, I don't know, like normal art, pardon me, like expression, the normal art that you could see, oh wow, that's awesome for being on art, piece of art, not just necessarily a political message.
Well, what I said, I take the part about this, popular music, it's probably proof of my entirely biased interest only in classical music, but I will make exception to play. I was talking about an original, we could have this conversation, but popular music, I think, would make a proper case. I don't know anything about popular music. To come back to your question, look, there's a distinguished tradition of 20th century Cuban painting that has academic, Wilfredo Lam being obviously the most important, I think it's fair to say, which has derivative interpreters at the moment in the the fate of arts abroad outside their own country is very peculiar. I mean, we don't really entirely understand why one work of art translates or resonates. Why does Botero matter to people but not other artists where he comes from? I'm going to give you just an obvious example. Why do educated people interested in literature, don't read Spanish, I'm talking about. Read Virgilio Piñero, but don't read Calvin Casey. I don't know the answer to that question, but it's true. Calvin Casey is always completely out of print in any language other than French and Spanish. And Virgilio Piñero is translated into 20 languages. The destiny of the arts, it also changes. Look, at some point, I was saying to Manuel that, I increasingly think that, the same jokes that that used to make me laugh about Franco now make me laugh about Castro. And, but I think it's rather this, if you want one political opinion from me, it's just as expanding. Maybe other things were possible in the past, but now those two guys simply have to die. It's a Garcia Marquez situation. It's too late for them to pass through the seat anyway. They have to be in the ground. Just like Franco, I was in Spain in the last years of Franco, so everyone knew it was over. But it had to last, he literally had to be in the ground. Hence the famous joke that was told at the time, which is, I'll tell very quickly, Franco's dying, the crowd assembles at the palace. Suddenly, to the stupefaction of the doctor, the dictator opens his eyes and said, "What's that noise?" And the doctor's question over, and they say, "Well, it's the people, people, what do they want?" And the doctor says, "Well, they come to say goodbye." To which Franco replies, "Goodbye, where are they going?" And, you tell the same macaw joke, which you all know about Castro, is, another version of, if you will, the same joke. Now, whether the art, what will happen to the arts in, as it were, the next republic? There will be a next republic. Probably sooner rather than later, terms. Then the question of the Second Republic, I guess you call. But you know, what that art will be and what and how it will resonate. Listen, how it will resonate in Cuba. Our politics unifies people, particularly the net. These posters, I would bet, you know, $100 against a plantain chip, are you know, perfectly intelligible to people on the island. I don't think they resonate. Other forms of art may not. Politics both divides in the obvious sense, but also unifies. And as people speak, it's the same narrative. You might disagree, but it's, you know, you're talking about the same thing. Do the Cuban artists I know in Paris, painters, are they, and who are exhibiting in galleries in Buenos Aires and in Rio and in New York, are they in Paris? Are they going to resonate with, you know, art students in 2020 in Havana or in Santiago? I don't know. That's the problem with, you know, what some literary critic in the 1920s called the afterlife of art. It's very independent.
We were talking about it, and we had the question of whether it resonates. I mean, is it presented in, I mean, could Cubans, people see it now, and what? Is your work being shown in Cuba? Is it possible? Websites or cell phone mode?
Perhaps. On the web, some people have, I have been told that a lot of people, young people have, like screensaver, they use my work in schools. I don't know if that's true. I don't know
where. So you don't have any feedback, or you don't...
Well, I do, the position knows my work. Other people, perhaps they have seen it, but there's lack of internet in Cuba, so...
One thing, the opposition does see it. I mean, Yoni Sanchez on her blog writes very about this work today, I think,
It's more than that. In a way, inside Cuba,
he knows.
The image of the civil society, the image of the opposition movement, was non-existent. It was a Cuban flag and a pair of handcuffs. And it's okay, but that was an image that came from maybe from the 19th century, not the handcuffs and the flag, the handcuffs and the flag. And suddenly, it appeared a component of playfulness, of beauty, in my opinion, of pleasure, of humor, with somehow of political imagination. Because I can't read in your posters what many people want to say, but sometimes cannot, or maybe do not know how to use to say it. No? And maybe you don't know. You do not know how to say it, but you can express it. So there is like something of a mystery in creation that is even beyond the control of the author. But suddenly, in Cuba, answering your question, it's very well known. And the other point is that, in my opinion, and we are jumping from aesthetics to reality, these posters recompose a Cuba which doesn't exist. A Cuba which is better in ethical terms than the real Cuba. Because many of these persons included in the poster, I am included in one of the posters, sometimes we do not behave as a whole. We behave like splinters, we have quarreling, we have distrust, we have apathy, we get tired, we get out of Cuba. And somehow these posters reconstitute that possible Cuba that maybe will never be. But out of beauty, out of moral, is there for the maybe for the next generation to do something better than what we can have been able to do. But in a way, it's like a poetic expression that transcends the real actors. So it's really very important.
Thank you.
Good. Very
well said.
And I have another question. How long have you been with this?
How long did you work in the
Around 5 years. Yes. Near 600.
I have a question. They are, you did them because you
want
or because somebody ordered them?
No, I took them by myself.
By yourself.
Of course, there are certain projects, like for example the LGBT walk in Havana.
This is a project in Cuba.
This is Cuba. So I collaborate with that.
That's very interesting.
yes, that's what I do. I make the posters and the logos for the projects. But it's mainly my own imagination.
So they asked you to do it, somebody in Cuba, or there was a campaign, or
exactly did they ask me? I know them. I know about the project, so there's a
okay. You collaborate.
Correct.
Una anécdota en cubano ahora.
All right.
En septiembre de 2012, cuando bueno, varias personas cayeron presas saliendo de sus casas porque íbamos al proyecto Estado del SAS a hablar de literatura, bueno, los arrestos siempre, aunque no te hagan nada, son violentos, son alante de tu familia, son en el barrio, te tratan como un delincuente, bajo una estación de policía, no sabes si es un día o una hora o tres días, estos arrestos express o bueno, hay para mí una señora, no, hay una señora... Hay una señora en Cuba que tiene 2 años y medio sin juicio.
Yeah.
Sin juicio, pero sí.
Orlando, say it in English because you're American.
Okay. I was telling that I was going to say a joke in English, in Spanish, but now it's in English. That on September 2012, a dozen of activists were arrested just by walking out of their home places. Because we were going to meet in a place for making some video conferences, the project is how it starts. Oh well, I was arrested in front of my mother, in front of my neighborhood, with a corresponding dose of violence, with a corresponding dose of not knowing, which is the final result of that, because there is no paperwork, they are taking you to a faraway police station, you don't know in which moment they are going to beat you, or if they will respect your integrity, so. And at that moment I was arrested with my girlfriend, Silvia Corbeyer, which is also a photographer and has nothing to do with the civil society, but she was arrested just for being there, just for being a witness, to avoid her to let the world know. But anyway, I was able to tweet during the arrest, and the world knew at that moment. And at some moment in the jails of the police station, Silvia was in the next calabozo, in the next jail, the next cell. And I said to her, there is a good news about this arrest. It was on a Saturday. Maybe this is a poster. Maybe we did it. And in fact, I didn't have to mention her name. She knew what I was saying. And in fact, when we came out at midnight that night, there was a lot of Twitter movement. There was a lot of social networking. And that poster from OLPR was made in 2 hours, maybe. No? Maybe it's a very simple poster, but trying to keep up with the moment. And I remember that I mentioned that to Silvia. I'm like, Silvia, don't worry, maybe we're lucky and we got a poster today. So it's like a legitimation of the what is going on in Cuba, recreating a history, as I mentioned, and preserving a memory. Because Cuba, as many totalitarian countries, is a country ill of lack of memory. And what happened last 3-4 years, including dead people, including hunger strikes, including a political assassination, will be very, very soon forgotten. So we only have that trace for the people that want to read it or leave it behind, you know, like a trace. That's what we can do after so many decades of totalitarianism, leaving a trace of that reality and trying to express some beauty in that trace. So,
Orlando, could we have this exhibit in Havana somehow?
No.
No, there are independent projects, not in a gallery in Havana, but nothing happens in galleries in Havana. There is no normal art in Havana. It would be like a mute art. Normal art would be mute art.
That was my point. I mean, I guess I don't know if I came across kind of like being pro Castro here. No, that wasn't. I was just wondering, because I'm a friend. Okay, I like to go against the normal, you know, cause of things. So, like, I was wondering if there could ever be an exposition of, like, the normal art of Havana, which is, like, people trying to do art, like, forced by a government that has nothing to do with art, but but yet they're trying to be artists, you know what I mean? Just to like show the world, like, oh yeah, we do have real artists.
Yeah, we have a lot of galleries in Havana, and a lot of cinemas, and a lot of movies, everything is normal.
In other words, like the art that Castro would like to see that is not politically motivated, but yet it's fake, because it's really not necessarily something that people really want to do, it's just like they're being...
No, in this moment, the Cuban Revolution is finished as an ideological, aesthetical process.
Okay.
So, that maybe was in the 70s,
okay,
social realism, etc. Now we have commercial, people trying to sell to foreigners, not to get into trouble, but to coach in some aspects of rafters, prostitution, some topics, no? Okay. But the moment you go into questioning the roots of the system, maybe you don't want to topple down the government, but you want to question the legitimacy of the system.
Then you get shut down.
But in Havana we have places like these, private houses.
That's
the house of Giovanni Sanchez, the house of Antonio Rodile from Estado de Sas, my own place at some moment. And then they have made some exposition of posters. Now, I don't know if some of them viewers, Rolando, but definitely for more like the cartoonist, Garrincha and other cartoonists, they made like a very critical exposition in a private house.
Have your house ever been raided?
Well,
no, not in those cases. I have presented even my independent magazine, which is completely critical to the government.
No, but not I meant raided like by the police, like, oh, okay.
So that's not risky, it's not dangerous to do that?
No, the political police behaves completely, it's the only free organism inside Cuba. They behave with absolute freedom. For the same event, they will raid your house and they will arrest you. Right now, Antunes has been arrested, or tonight, now it's arrested. Wow. For something much more serious, meeting some foreigner, nothing happens. Yeah. So it's completely unpredictable. No, that's why it's a model of where law, the rule of law, is nonsense.
I wanted to say that I found out about this event, Diario de Cuba. I work two blocks from here, that's why I made it here. And I mean, it's great that there are English-speaking people here, but I think we have to make a greater effort to gather the Cuban community because this is very important. Just a small request.
It is very difficult to gather.
Yes, it is. Oh, yes.
Not really.
You want to bring them from Miami?
I can invite everybody. Next Sunday, Central Park, come to the Rumba Cubana where we be playing the drum, and you'll be seeing the Cuban community that really
extends to
But I wanted to mention that there are, I mean, you are showing deep problems in Cuba, but there also there is cholera in Cuba. The government is lying on TV, is lying on the news, is lying on the newspapers. They don't say anything about cholera. There is huge problems with garbage collection too, and all Cubans should get involved on these issues. And I wish, as a request, you could somehow show these illnesses that are killing many Cubans.
Well, I do. He
does. Oh, I just I can't even.
Yeah. There's one. Show your advertising.
Girls, boys, bitches, bonitos, music,
thank you. Wow.
By the way,
there's another issue.
If anybody should fall in love with one of these posters, they're for sale. And they're for sale. Yes, I think.
Good.
Somebody get the
the light and continue.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for coming.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.